It's the book of Jeremiah, chapter 8 and verse 15.
Bring it up.
We look for peace.
So this is talk about the so-called black man.
Right.
We in America looking for peace. That's why when you see us marching, what do we yell?
Bring
it up. Every protest, what do we yell? No justice, no peace.
That's right.
That's Bible prophecy. The Bible is a black man's book.
That's right.
For over 40 years, we've been marching in the streets looking for peace, yelling no justice, no peace.
Right.
You don't see the Chinese marching in the streets yelling no justice, no peace.
Bring it up.
You don't see the Arabs marching in the streets yelling no justice, no peace.
Bring it up.
And if you see the white man marching in our neighborhoods yelling it, guess what? 9 times out of 10, they are informants.
That's
they
right.
are about to set us up.
Right.
Read.
We look for peace, but no good came.
So even when we look for peace, when we go out in the streets and yell no justice, what? No peace, what happened? We end up getting tear gas.
That's right.
We done protest police brutality, but while we trying to protest police brutality, the police come and beat us down.
Right.
That's right.
This Bible is a black man's book. Read, and Hispanic man's book.
And for a time for help.
And what?
And for a time of help.
So then a time of help, then a coronavirus. We marching in the streets saying no justice, no peace.
Read that last part again. And for a time of health.
So we looking for health. We got older black men and black women going to the hospital to get healed. And what did the doctor tell them? Sorry, we don't have no vaccination for you.
That's right.
Sorry, we can't test you for coronavirus. Go
Bring
home and die, Negro.
Right.
Go home and die, spit. This is a Bible prophecy.
That's right.
Read.
And behold, trouble.
And what?
And behold, trouble.
So what happened when you go to the hospital?
Bring it
up. You go to the hospital to get treated for your sickness, and you go to jail.
Right.
That's Bible prophecy. Wake up, black man. Wake up, Hispanic man. Y'all God's chosen people.
That's right.
Read.
It's the book of Jeremiah, chapter 8 and verse 15.
Bring it up.
Read. Look.
Get Psalms 10 and 8. Get Psalms 10 and 8. Because what y'all going to learn today is this Bible is not a fairy tale.
That's right.
This is not a book of myths. This Bible is the most, this is the only book that our people should have their head in day and night.
That's right.
This Bible is the most relevant book on the face of earth today.
That's right.
Read.
It's the book of Psalms, chapter 10 and verse 8. He sitteth in the lurking places.
So who is this talking about? This is talking about your enemies. I'll let you put two and two together. So the Bible says your enemies sitteth in the lurking places. Read.
Of the villages.
Of the villages. Guess what the villages is today?
Bring it up.
The villages is your stop six.
Right.
The villages is Las Vegas Trail.
That's
in other words, the villages is the hoods today in America.
Right.
So I say your enemies, they go to the hoods and they lurk. They prey on our people.
Right.
So guess what? Amara Aubrey, guess what was happening? They was lurking for Amara.
That's right.
Amara Aubrey.
That's
Bible prophecy. Read.
Oh. In the secret places.
And what?
In the secret places.
You know what the secret places? You know what they look at in the secret places? When the police get at the bottom of the hill, so when you come over the top, you can't see them so they can catch you speeding.
That's right.
That's them hunting you when they park under the trees.
That's right.
If police is here to protect and serve our people, then why the hell they gotta hide from us?
Right.
That makes no sense.
Bring it up. As a matter of fact,
our kids are scared of police.
That's right.
Read.
In the secret places, doth he murder the innocent.
Do he do what?
Doth he murder the innocent.
So in the hoods, they come to the hoods and they murder Amara Aubrey. Guess what? At that time, Amara Aubrey was innocent.
That's right.
He wasn't committing no crimes.
Right.
The brother, what's the brother name that died the other day?
George Floyd.
Guess what? At that time, that brother was innocent.
Right.
They say he handed them a counterfeit $20 bill. How the hell can you look at a counterfeit $20 and know what it is?
That's right.
Read.
His eyes are privily set against the poor.
His what?
His eyes are privily set against the poor.
In other words, they only want to arrest you. They only want to shoot you down in the streets.
Right.
That's why black and Hispanics make up 80% of the prison population.
That's right.
That makes no sense. Read that last part again.
His eyes are privily set against the poor.
So guess what? When you see the police in your neighborhood, guess what? That's Bible prophecy. Read.
It's the book of Psalms, chapter 10 and verse 8.
Bring it up.
He sitteth in the lurking places of the villages.
Read.
In the secret places doth he murder the innocent.
Right.
His eyes are privily set against the poor.
Right. I go to Habakkuk 1 and 4. Habakkuk 1 and 4. Because a lot of our people think, that's just a coincidence.
See?
If we keep fighting the justice system, if we keep going to court, then maybe our enemies will stand up for us one day.
See?
Right.
The slave master is never going to show the slave how to get free.
That's right.
That makes no sense. Free.
This is the book of Habakkuk, chapter 1 and verse 4. But for the law, it's lack.
So guess what? The laws that America got set up today, the Constitution is not for the black man.
That's right.
The Bible says the laws in America are slack. That's why every time a police killer unarmed black man, it's rare that he even go to court.
Right.
The law in America is slack. It's not set up for you, black man.
That's right.
We hope they get Isaiah 30 and 2.
Don't bring it out.
Isaiah 30 and 2, hold that. So the law in America is slack. It's not set up for you. So what the heck make you think that we can vote our way out of oppression?
That's right.
Guess what? Election season is coming up soon.
Right.
A lot of our people say what? Vote or die. You dying and you voting.
That's right.
That makes no sense. America's laws are not set up for you black and Hispanic men. Read.
It's the book of Isaiah, chapter 30 and verse 2.
Bring it on.
That walk to go down into Egypt.
So guess what? The Bible said the so-called black and Hispanic man, we want to go down into America. America is Egypt.
That's
America
right.
is the place of our bondage. Baby.
Right. Right.
Hey, brother, come over here. We out here for you. Come look at the signs for me.
I know I'm Israel.
Then come over here and talk to me.
America's done.
Hold that. Hey, come over here, brother, and talk to me. Hold that. Get numbers 32 and 6. Don't drop what you got. Numbers 32 and 6.
Teach up.
Come over here and top it up with me, bro.
So 32 and 6?
Yeah. This is the book of Numbers, chapter 32 and verse 6.
Bring it out.
And Moses said unto the children of Gad.
What's your name, bro?
Rod.
Rod. Hey, Rod, do me a favor, uncover your hair real quick, because I want to top it up with you. So this, what I'm finna say to you is the same thing that Moses said to our forefathers, because you said you know you Israel, read.
And Moses said unto the children of Gad.
Just like we said to you today, Rod, let's see what he said.
And to the children of Reuben, shall your brethren go to war, and shall ye sit here?
So what is Moses asking them? The children of Gad and the children of Reuben. He said, shall your brethren go to war, and you sit here? You know you Israel, so you would know right now we are at war.
That's right.
When the police shooting us down in our communities, guess what? That is acts of war.
That's right.
When they kidnap our women and sell them for sex slaves, guess what? Those are acts of war.
So read the last part again. Shall your brethren go to war?
Shall your brethren go to war?
So, right. So you come out. So we go to war. So we come out here and teach the people the right way to live. And you know you Israel and what?
And shall ye sit here?
So you know that our people are going through oppression right now. If you know you Israel, then 9 times out of 10, you know how to get them out of that oppression, which is the Bible. But you're not doing that. That's the same thing our forefathers did. That's why he said, should your brethren go to war and you sit here and watch?
Right. That's right.
That makes no sense.
That's right.
19 and 59. So let me ask you, how do you know you Israel?
But first, they're 12
tribes out here. What's wrong about it?
All 12 tribes in
Israel. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 29.
Bring it out,
see, this is
bring
the thing. I've heard that thing before. And to say that, you got to prove your point. You know what I'm saying? So watch this. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 21.
Bring it out.
It's the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 5 and verse 21.
Bring it out.
Prove all things.
So guess what? We can go through this sign and prove that every tribe is who we say they is on this Bible.
But
you can't go through the Bible and prove to me that the Hispanic
all 12 tribes are Negro.
Prove it, bro. Prove it. Hold on. Hey, step back. Step back. Hold on. You straight. We'll give you a Bible. We'll give you a Bible. You need a Bible?
That's wrong.
Prove it. Prove it. Who's your elders? You're not even on the streets. That's the problem. Hey, bro, listen. Hey, sisters, y'all come in real quick. Hey, listen, bro. We not gonna stop
with you.
Hey, sisters, what we are here to teach is the according to the Bible, y'all are blind to the people. Come here. I want y'all to come in.
Y'all elders are deceiving y'all, bro.
Because y'all got y'all kids with y'all, and that's important. Hey, bro, we not here to argue. So if you're not gonna listen to the Bible, you can kick rocks.
I can kick rocks. But y'all deceiving the people. That 12 tribes sign is wrong.
Let me ask you. You up here talking about the 12 tribes song is wrong. Meanwhile, you got your sisters walk down the street and God knows who's going to come and kill
you. Ain't for everybody, bro.
So anyway, yeah, obviously it's not for
everybody,
for you.
Bro.
So anyway,
no,
sis, let me ask you, what's your nationality?
Who y'all elders following? Say y'all up, man.
Kick rock.
Don't I say be circumspect. Y'all not being circumspect right now, bro.
See, get up.
Y'all not being circumspect, bro.
See, look, that's the problem. We are here to teach the so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Most times say be circumspect. Y'all not being circumspect right now.
Romans 3 and 3. Look, if you really love your people.
Y'all causing attention, bro.
Look, if you really loved your people, if you was really about the Bible, then you wouldn't be quiet while we talk to
sisters. You would do this in preview.
Because look, you said,
you at your...
Get Titus to the preview.
Bring it out, bro.
How can a fucking Puerto Rican people born to the Bible, then you want to shut your mouth while I'm trying to teach the Negro woman.
Bring it out,
bro.
They, how can they be part of the Trail Tribe when they are the other nations in the Revelation?
Just listen. Right, listen.
I don't have to listen. I know who I'm talking about.
Brother,
y'all elders are setting y'all up, bro.
Brother.
Y'all elders are setting y'all up, bro.
No, what I'm saying.
What is your question? Y'all elders are setting y'all up, bro.
No, I said, what was your question? Which tribe is
saying? All 12 tribes are Negro.
All 12 tribes are Negro.
All 12 of them are Negro.
Then look at these pictures right here.
All of them will be part of the 144.
You read Deuteronomy 28, right?
Yes, five men.
So who's the people that was on the slave ships?
Bring it up.
That Moses prophesied.
That was us. They went on damn slave ships, bro.
Bruh, they was on a slave ship too. Yes.
No, they was not.
Yes, they was.
12 tribes.
Yes, they was. They send them to Europe. They was on a slave ship. They send the Native Americans to Europe. I'm a Native American. I know.
A slave.
They had us in slavery too. They was in slavery. They fit the prophecy, brother.
You got to
read the prophecy. No, it's not, brother. Listen, bro.
Bring it on.
You got to hold it down. Listen, brother.
Most High there with y'all, bro. And y'all say you're not
even Christ. Give me Deuteronomy. Give me one. Give me the scripture that says that the nation. They're going to come far above.
They're deceiving us, man. 49. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 49.
Listen, that's
the
Negro,
Lord
man.
Shall bring a nation against thee from far, from the end of the earth, as swift as the eagle fleeth.
Who is the eagle? Why? What is the symbol of the eagle?
Teach,
no, no. The so-called white man, right?
Man,
throughout
the
history, his symbol is the eagle. What's the eagle? What's the symbol?
Okay, we know that.
All right, now listen. That's what we're trying to get to. But you saying the Northern Kingdom, you say the Northern Kingdom brothers are not Israel. That's what you're saying.
That's what you just said. Only Negroes.
Brothers, not just Negroes, brother. All these people.
It's an American Indian, a Dominican, a Cuban, a Puerto Rican, a Haitian. When they all hate us, how are they part of the Trail Tribe?
Because
they hate us. Because
they divided us, brothers.
They divided us.
You got to understand the history. They divide us by
y'all
the religion, brother.
Bro.
They divide
that's
us.
Not, that's, this is
they divided
that's
us.
That's book of Genesis. How can they be part of the Trail Tribe when they're the other nation?
14.
Bring it on.
It's a car. Is a strong ass.
So Issachar is a strong ass.
Right.
What people you know that work 2-3 jobs that can work all day?
Bring
who you see out in the highway being oppressed, working on the highways, working on these buildings over here every day? Who's the ones getting paid low? They get paid low wages, bro. And they can't come over in this land.
Right.
And they call them aliens. They got a word. They got a nerve to call them aliens. So they catching hell too, just like us. They live in the ghetto just like us too. You ever been to Mexico?
Bring it up, man. I didn't go to Mexico. Why the hell would I go to Mexico when I'm hating across?
Because we're supposed to go out there and wake our people up.
That's right. Everybody.
They was in captivity with the Spaniards.
Most I say everybody can't get this, man.
Go ahead.
Issachar is a strong ass, catching down between two burdens.
They have two burdens. They have two burdens.
Oh, Negroes.
But brother, hey.
Come on, bro.
Hey.
That's the only thing. Hey,
you don't believe what the scripture says? Hey.
What you mean over the scripture?
Hey, we reading from the scripture.
Because I know the Most High with me. He ain't with y'all.
How's he with you?
I know he with me.
How's he with you?
I know he with me. I heard the frequency.
Okay.
Yeah. I had an extra talk.
Where your fringes at?
Frequency.
Bring it.
Get that. Get the fringes.
Bring it out.
Where's the fringes at? No. Where's the fringes at?
Because I know that's wrong. And I need
how do you become a man?
I'm going to get y'all killed,
how do you become a man?
Y'all elders going to get y'all killed,
how do you become a man?
Y'all elders
what is your purpose
going
to
get y'all killed.
What is your purpose
y'all
on earth?
Y'all elders, my purpose
yes.
is to know why I'm a slave in America and know
read
what
this.
My promise is.
You get the purpose. What's the purpose?
I'm getting tenfold, baby. I know mine's.
Get First Kings chapter 2, seven wise, verse 2.
The seven means
what is your purpose on earth?
My purpose. Well, right now,
if you know you're Israel, what is your purpose on earth?
Right now, America's done. We do, but that
this is the book of First Kings, chapter 2 and verse 2.
Bring it on.
I go the way of all the earth. Be thou strong, therefore, and show
all 12 tribes of Negro.
And keep the charge of the Lord thy God.
Keep the charge of the Lord thy God. How you keep the charge of the Lord thy God?
Bring it out,
you're supposed to go out here and tell your people and bring them back to God's commandments.
Right.
But while we're here on earth, we got to rehearse the righteous acts, brother.
Right.
To walk in his ways.
To walk in his ways. That's why we so divided, because we didn't keep God's commandments, man.
Right.
We divided because of slavery.
No, we divided because we didn't keep God's commandments, brother.
We didn't keep the Torah like we're supposed to, brother.
Listen to what I'm saying.
To keep his statutes and
the
his commandments.
To keep his statutes.
That's the word. So how the fuck they brought you to
the word of Israel.
Go to Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15. Because we cursed, brother, because we didn't keep God's laws.
Of course we didn't. 40 years.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, and verse 15. But it shall come to pass.
Feed your pets. This is Moses prophesying us. We was in the wilderness. Go ahead.
If thou will not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
And we don't hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God.
To observe to do all his commandments.
To observe.
Show me what Haitian the Bible Twitter tribe.
And his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
These curses are good or bad?
I'm still finding a way to fuck it up.
These curses are good or bad? Curses are a good thing or a bad thing?
Curses are a bad thing. We curse right now, bro. But in a couple more months, we won't. They can bring this bitch down. How about that?
We already know that in the prophecy.
They're not going to bring that.
The Most High is going to destroy it.
That's right, bro.
The Most High God's going to do that.
The man of Allah is coming y'all way, bro. Jael is sending y'all up.
Most High is going to destroy this place. But before he comes, he wants us to wake up and get back to God's commandments.
That's right. Everybody can't be woke. Seriously, y'all ain't woke enough to know that that shit is wrong.
How you know it's wrong? How do you know it's wrong?
It's just the fucking word. Mexicans, Argentina, Colombia, American Indians, Dominicans, Cubans, Puerto Ricans.
Yes.
Haitians don't even like us. They hate us.
Yes.
They
because they divide us, man. They divide us. The enemy divide us to keep us confused and keep us bound. That's one of the curses.
It's a rap.
Give me the one with the byword.
Y'all gonna die horrible death, man.
Give me the byword.
Y'all fucking over.
Book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 37.
Bring it on.
And thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations whither the Lord shall lead thee.
Read again.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, and verse 37.
Bring it out.
And thou shalt become an astonishment.
Milk.
So we're an astonishment. Who you see walking around our pants sagging on our butts?
Bring it out.
Our sisters dressed like whores. Our people in the midst of wickedness. Go ahead.
A proverb and a byword.
A proverb. A proverb, like to say that all black people like fried chicken and watermelon.
Bring it up.
That the Mexicans eat beans and tacos all the time.
Bring
that up. Go ahead.
And a byword.
And a byword. They call us a different nationality outside our God-given name.
That's right.
We was trying to teach the brother. The brother wanted to humble down and listen. He wanted to humble down and listen and understand why. And we was going to show him too why Northern Kingdom was part of Israel. So he don't even understand the history. Go ahead.
Among all nations, whither the Lord shall lead thee.
Among all the nations, what?
Among all nations, whither the Lord shall lead thee.
With the Lord shall lead thee. The Most High, he used those nations to divide us and to confuse us.
What?
To take our heritage away. Most High used the other nations to divide us. That's why we confused. That's why a lot of us don't know who we are according to the Bible. The Most High God woke us up to come out here to let our people know.
That's right.
But we got brothers that they don't want to humble down and listen. They don't want to learn this Bible. They don't understand the prophecy that Moses brought out.
Right.
He's like he said, if you don't keep God's commandments, the curse is going to fall on us.
Right.
We're going to lose the heritage and everything.
Right.
The only way that we're going to be on top, the only way Christ is going to save us is getting back to God's commandments.
We used to scream black power while Haran was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.